We're going to be at Miller's Motorsports, bagging our buddy Philip Evans' OBS Chevrolet.
So we're going to take all this pile of garbage and put it on this pile of garbage. So on the OBS, we've got to get the C-notch in. The good thing about these OBSs is this bolt hole right here, it's centered up with the rear end. So all we have to do is get our C-notch centered to this hole here, and our C-notch is centered.
Dude, why do we even put tape measures on anything around here, son?
Tack.
All right, so that's your C-notch welded in,
tied in.
We have to cut all this out, and then there's plate that goes in here, plate that goes in here, plate that goes in there, finishes tying it in. Then there's a piece of pipe that we call a bridge that will bridge the two together to hold them from being able to go in and out. All this does is keep your C-notch frame from folding in.
Thanks, Philip, for making sure you filled your tank all the way up before we got to pull it. Appreciate it.
We're going to pull out the tank because this Crossmember actually has to come out. It gets replaced. But mainly I want to pull the tank because we're about to cut this with the plasma and plate everything in. We got to get some welds in back here, and the tank's kind of in the way. So luckily this truck is sitting in full drive status, so
should be all
too hard to get everything out. See, not the frame all cut out. You gotta take this plate to weld it up under here, these two plates weld to the side to finish boxing this thing in. So all right, so the factory gas tank Crossmember is out. You gotta grind the rivets down, punch them out from the top and bottom. That's where the raised tank gas member, Crossmember, for the gas tank from Nfamus goes in. It's a two-piece. There's two holes that line up, and then you have to drill two holes. We're gonna get it lined up, and then we'll show you where you gotta drill the holes and all that good kind of stuff. All right, so on your Nfamus kit for the raised tank Crossmember, this side of the Crossmember will line up with all three of the factory holes. Then on this side, you have the factory hole back hole that it lines up there. You gotta drill that hole. Bada bing, bada boom, it's installed. Crossmember in, we've got our wishbone in. To set up the wishbone properly, set the truck at what's called half travel. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna jack the truck up, put the rear end on jack stand. We already checked our pinion angle. It's at -9 on this truck. We just need to make sure our pinion angle stays there. So we're gonna jack the truck up, put jack stands on the rear end, pull the leaf springs out, and let the truck down. Because as you can see right now, our wishbone does not push down, going over the center of our rear end. As we pick our rear end up, it will go over the center of it. So. All right, so now we got the rear end straight and everything. So now we just, you put your tabs in, your wishbone, and tack them to the frame. To the rear end. All right, so we got our wishbone tacked in. Now you just take your lower bars, put your tabs in, make sure they're on the right side. So you got a bung in the side for your shock, and you have your bag bolt through the top. You want your tabs on the rear side closest to the bung. If you see, the bung is closer to one side than the other. So your shock goes into your C-notch, so therefore you want this closer. So you set them up, make sure it's on the right side because you only got, you know, driver's side, passenger side. So I got this one. Already in, I gotta tap it in. I'm gonna put the bolt through, lift it up to the rear end, tack it in, and do the same thing on the other side. Then we'll pull the wishbone and the bottom bars out and clean it up and let him run it and weld it. Make sure you weld your rear end to your frame somehow. Get it lower, like we have it sitting here, what you would consider half travel, which would be half travel. You figure out how high your truck would be fully aired up. take a measurement, what it would be on the ground. Kind of want to be half in there. I've come to learn that that is pretty much your rear end, your frame sitting on the rear end. I've set them up like that, set up lots of trucks like that, and it worked.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a broken OBS. Look, it's broke. It's tooted, ball. Yep, so she laid out. I want y'all to look at something. I'm going to show y'all something. This is why we don't run two links. This is why we run four links or three links.
Right, see that pinion angle? Lay it down. Slow, though, because I don't want to break my camera. Go ahead. Y'all notice how that pinion angle did not move at all, or four link, whether it's parallel, triangulated, whatever. Your pinion angle, as you go up and down, your rear end stays in one spot. Pinion angle never moves. If you are on a two link, because your rear end is mounted static, when you go up or down on your two link, your rear end does this. And your pinion angle changes. Now, we gotta take bag brackets. So this is your bag bracket. The way your infamous three link is made to set up, you've gotta cut this much, the thickness of this plate in the back, out of the frame. And then this is gonna come in from the back, like so, and weld in down here. I'm gonna show you when I cut it out. What that does, put your bag bracket out here, but it cups the frame, so your bag sits about halfway into the frame and it goes into that bolt hole right there. So that's what we're gonna do next.